So as an engineer, I've got a few top tips about how to successfully set up your home for a mapping run with your robot. Firstly, I'd set up your dock correctly. We've got other videos and there's content in the app about how to do this properly. Then I'd spend some time preparing your home for the robot to start mapping. So firstly, I'd tidy away any small obstacles like phone cables or clothing, for example, that the robot may get stuck on. It's then also worth thinking about any larger things like chairs or deep pile rugs, which the robot also may get stuck on. It's worth thinking about temporarily putting these into another room or out the way, but just for the mapping process. Once you've created a good map, you can then actually mark areas on the app where a chair could be, for example, and the robot will avoid getting stuck in that chair in the future. It's then also worth just double checking that all the doors for the rooms you want to map are wide open and the robot can get into those rooms. But then if you give yourself a couple of hours and follow all these tips, you should be able to successfully generate a really good map. So when the robot starts mapping, it will move off the dock and then it will split all of the area it can see into a grid. It'll then clean the first grid, the second grid, so on and so forth, until it's cleaned all of the area it can reach in your home. Within each grid, it'll follow a spiral cleaning pattern, which is the most efficient way for it to navigate around your home. So the robot needs to create a really accurate map of your home. For larger homes, this may take a couple of hours. For smaller homes, it may be slightly less. It's dependent on the size of your home. When the robot's mapping, it will follow the same path that it does when it cleans. It just turns the vacuum and the brush bar off to save energy. So before you start mapping, it's worth just putting aside a couple of hours to allow the robot to complete this process so that you get an accurate map back at the end. So yes, you can create multiple maps for multiple floors in your home. So for example, if you wanted to map upstairs, simply take the dock and the robot upstairs and then start another mapping run from the app. When this is complete, you'll get a notification that there's another map ready in the app. You can then go into the app and then name that as the upstairs map, for example, or the ground floor map. So when the robot completes a mapping run, we turn the vacuum and the brush bar motor off. This means the robot uses a lot less energy, so it means it can generate one single good map of the home without the home environment changing too much and creating an inaccurate map. So your robot should have enough charge to map even the largest of homes. However, if the robot does need to recharge in the middle of a mapping run, the robot will automatically navigate back to the dock and recharge there. It takes about an hour and a half for it to recharge, but once that's complete, the robot will go back to where it left off and continue the mapping. However, if you've come home and the robot's in the middle of the room and it's unpowered, this probably means the robot hasn't been able to navigate back to the dock to recharge automatically. So to solve this, you need to pick up the robot yourself, place it back on the dock, and allow it to recharge. Once that's complete, you'll need to start another mapping run and allow it to cover your entire home to generate a full map. So there are a couple of issues which you could experience during a mapping run, which could result in either a partial or no map being generated by the robot. Firstly, if you pick up the robot yourself and place it back on the dock during a mapping run, this could result in issues with your map. It's really important to allow the robot to map your whole home and return to the dock on its own. Also, if your robot gets stuck during a mapping run, you'll see some orange warning lights on the robot itself, and you'll also get a notification on the app. If you just follow the instructions on the app about how to recover your robot, it should be able to then continue mapping and return to dock on its own and generate a map for you. If you've noticed on the app your robot's only generated a partial map of your home, I'd recommend restarting the mapping process. It's really important for your robot to try and map your home in one go. This is because if your home environment changes too much in between two mapping runs, it may change the accuracy of the map, and this could affect some of the functionality you want to use later on. So if your robot hasn't been able to get into a room during a mapping run, perhaps because the door is shut, then it won't be able to add it to the map. One way to add this area to the map is to make sure that room is accessible during future cleans and complete several cleans, making sure the robot can get into that room. Then you can check back on the app and see if the robot has added that room to the map. However, the best way to add a room that the robot has missed onto the map is to complete a new mapping run, making sure a door is open to that room and the robot gets in there. Then it will generate an accurate map of your home all in one go. So if your robot gets stuck whilst mapping, you'll get a notification on the app. There will then be some more information on the app about how you can recover the fault. And once that's completed, you can press the play button on the robot and it will continue mapping. I really advise not to pick up the robot whilst mapping and placing it back on the dock. This is because if you do that halfway through a mapping run, it won't generate a map, and you'll have to start the mapping process again. So it's really worthwhile preparing your home, so ensuring that the robot can map your entire house in one go, and successfully get back to the dock on its own with that whole home map. So if your robot repeatedly gets stuck during mapping, so for example if it's getting stuck on a chair, it may be worth just temporarily moving that chair out of the way during the mapping run. The benefit of this is that once you've completed a successful mapping run, you can zone your home and then you can put areas down on the map where it will always avoid that chair or it won't climb onto that chair. So it may feel like a bit of effort to prepare your home for mapping, but I think it's really, really worth it if you get the benefit of all these future features after you've completed the mapping run.